The engine for our Artemis Moon rocket is all fired up, final launch preparations for an historic mission, and how you can hear back billions of years into the past. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. On August 5th, engineers at our Stennis Space Center conducted the sixth RS-25 engine hot fire test of the current seven-part test series. Four RS-25s will help power the Space Launch System rocket on future moon missions, including Artemis 1, targeted for later this year. For more details, visit nasa.gov/SLS. Our Lucy spacecraft arrived recently at our Kennedy Space Center and was transported to nearby Astrotech for final launch preparations. Lucy's 23-day launch window opens October 16th. It will be the first space mission to the Trojan asteroids, a diverse population of small bodies, believed to be remnants of our early solar system that are trapped in stable orbits associated with the planet Jupiter. Learn more at nasa.gov/Lucy. From August 2nd through the 6th, we celebrated the Hubble Space Telescope's iconic deep field images that have revolutionized our understanding of the universe. This sonification of the Hubble Ultra Deep Field image plays a note as the captured light emitted by each galaxy shows up in the image. The farther away the galaxy is, the longer its light traveled before reaching Hubble. In the sonification, which is just under a minute long, we can hear back nearly 13 billion years to the farthest galaxies in the image. NASA's Spacesuit User Interface Technologies for Students, or SUITS Challenge, is looking for college students to create graphical spacesuit information displays within augmented reality environments for a simulated mission to the moon. Technologies like this could help astronauts on future Artemis lunar surface exploration missions. For more about this and other ways you can be part of the Artemis mission, check out stem.nasa.gov/Artemis. We demonstrated our scalable traffic management for emergency response operations, or STEREO project, during a recent wildfire simulation in Northern California to show how the technology can help emergency responders work more safely and effectively. STEREO uses NASA's expertise in drone traffic management to provide a way to coordinate an emergency response effort that keeps assets in the air and on the ground in close contact, but safely out of each other's way. NASA's all-electric X-57 Maxwell experimental aircraft has completed high-voltage testing, another milestone toward first flight. High-voltage testing powers the aircraft from an auxiliary power supply to test the functionality of the integrated systems under full power. Next up, the X-57 will undergo verification and validation testing. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.